tendency for the parent of a picky eater is to force the child, right? I recently had a child, very sweet little girl, but she's afraid of food. That's because when she doesn't eat, the mother feels overwhelmed. She ends up beating her up. She ends up forcefully feeding her, threatening her, blackmailing, etc. So the first thing is you should not be doing that. Do not force feed. Although that's your tendency and you really want to force feed, somehow get the child to eat, please do not do that. The second tendency is to have a distraction and feed the child. The TV is on, or the laptop, or the phone, or a gadget is in front of the child, and then parents try to feed, hoping that somehow something gets into the child. That's the second thing you must completely avoid. Thirdly, parents tend to blackmail the child. They say, if you don't eat, boogeyman will come and take you. Or if you don't eat, I'll take you to the doctor for an injection. If you don't eat, then you don't love me. If you don't eat, then I'm not going to give you a favorite toy. You don't eat, then I don't give you ice cream. You see, everything is very conditional. You do this, then it's that. Or consequential. You don't do this, that will happen. You have to stop all of these practices. Why? Because when you do these practices that I just mentioned, you are instilling fear and anxiety in the child. And by instilling anxiety, do you really think your child is going to eat? I want you to think. Now, when you are anxious about something, would you feel like eating at that time? Or would you feel like working on that anxiety-provoking situation in a way that you can get rid of it? How do you deal with that situation or with that emotion? We wouldn't really want to eat when we are anxious, isn't it? So how can we force our children to eat by inducing anxiety in them? For these reasons, complete no-no for forcing children to eat or coercing them with benefits, or you know, trying to emotionally blackmail them by don't do this, etc. Completely stop this. That is the first thing you have to do with a picky eater. The second thing is don't overappreciate them. For example, sometimes if a picky eater tries to eat a new food, then the parent gets super excited and like, wow, you ate. Come on, everybody, let's clap our hands. And that is it, especially if that picky eater is someone who's strong-willed, who wants to feel powerful. The fact that you appreciated them, they'll be like, I don't want to eat it again. No, I actually didn't like it. And then also I see parents using these kind of terminologies or these kind of statements, I would say rather. You told me you don't like it. Now, how did it get into your mouth? See, you ate it. So you're trying to prove that you're right. And what if your child wants to prove that they are right? And although they can, they're going to say, no, I won't. Right? It all depends on the nature of the child as well. So having said that, avoid all of this that I just mentioned to you about not forcing the child, not emotionally blackmailing the child, or even over appreciating the child. All of these will work counterproductive to your picky eater. What I mean by a trial plate is you have a small little plate beside the child's plate on which you have actually put the food. And then tell the child, hey, look, today I have prepared something which I thought it'd be good if you would try. You see, all my sentence construction, I thought it would be good if you could try. I never said that it will be good, you must try. See, the way you put it across. So with a very pleasant way of bringing that to the child, you place it on the trial plate. Now, why a trial plate? Because children have a tendency to feel that, or even us grown-ups feel that, if something is on my plate, I have to eat it. But it's not the same with a trial plate, right? So children are more likely to test the trial plate. And also here, they have an option of leaving it behind the trial plate. They're not enforced to finish it. So in that way, there are more chances that he will try it again. But what if the child says, I tried it, but I don't like it. What do we do then? Then you could tell the child, yeah, I understand you won't like it the very first go, but trust me, we're going to try it again a couple of more times. Maybe you like it at that time. We'll give it a try. You know, this kind of a positive way of putting it across in such a manner that you're not judgmental, you're not stressing the child, you're not sounding that you're enforcing the child, but you're having safe negotiations, which makes the child feel safe and secure with you. This is one of the ways to help a picky eater overcome picky eating. Why? Because you're giving the child the autonomy. You're giving him the control over the food rather than having the food control him or her. Yeah, this is one very good way. I don't want to give too many pointers here because it will be too much of information. But this one pointer, if you can take home and try, I'm sure it's going to work out very well for you.